Good evening, YouTube. Well, we're out here at the garden after the rain, 48 hours after it rained an inch and a half the other day, very quickly. And I have been tasked with coming out here and picking the garden today. What we're going to do is try to walk down the rows and kind of get caught up after the rain. Anything that's a vine is beginning to take off at an enormous rate. So I'm probably going to skip over using the drip irrigation or tape irrigation, which you can see down here. If you've never looked into that, please look into it. It saves you so much money. It does cost for your initial investment, but everything seems to grow so much quicker and start producing fruit a lot quicker. We've done established the last two rows over here to the right. There is nothing on them. I really need to get a tiller back in there and make two more rows and think of something else to grow. Not bad. That'll be probably the second squash of this year. We're gonna let those go a little bit longer, but as you can tell, there's blooms everywhere. The rain the other day, I thought was gonna knock a bunch of the blooms off. Apparently, once I got over it, like this one here, this one here is all folded over, but I'll be one to bet you tomorrow it's standing up straight just like its little neighbor right over here. And for the folks that don't know, and that was including me until about a couple of months ago, these are my broccoli plants. Now, I never have grown a broccoli plant before ever until this year. Someone gave them to me and said, hey, try them out. And it was way back early in the season, probably about early March. So we decided to throw them in the ground, see what happened. Well, we threw them in the ground, we got broccoli on every single plant. Big, pretty broccoli spears. Well, this is what happens after the broccoli just gets too hot. And it's called, what it's doing now, it's bolting. If I understand it correctly, and someone correct me if I'm wrong, all these up here are going to be producing seeds. Now, I'm not sure how to get the seeds out. I don't know if you just take this and pop it off or whatever. I'm glad for any comments or how to do that. I'd like to have some broccoli next year. I might even try to plant some broccoli in the hydroponic system. Best I understand it is once this happens, your broccoli is over. The general consensus is once the plant bolts and starts growing up like this, very sparsely and producing like it is, the plant gets more bitter. So I'm not sure. I'm not going to taste these because I'm not a real broccoli fan. That'd be my wife, but apparently these would be a lot more bitter than the big broccoli head that formed earlier. Let me go back up here to the acorn squash and catch them also, since they're part of the squash family. I notice we do have a small acorn squash right here. And there was a little bit bigger one somewhere down through here. Here we go. A little bit bigger one. Now, I'm not real sure about acorn squash. This is the first time we've ever planted them. I know apparently they're more like a watermelon vine because that is basically two plants right there that you see. And it's about 10 foot. One plant going 5 foot toward me, one plant 5 foot away from me. And what I'd like to know is, when am I supposed to pick this? Right now it's green, apparently. So I've heard once it starts turning yellow on one side or changing colors, getting stripes, that's when you pick it. I'm open to anything that y'all have to say about it. Okay, here we have eggplant. Eggplant, I can tell real quick we need to put some diatomaceous earth or DE on all these plants. They had the big leaves, something starting to try to chew on them and gnaw them down. I planted the cucumbers in cages this year just to see. And for whatever reason, this one, it must have some really good dirt right there because it's almost up to the top, and that's at least a 5 foot tall cage. As you can tell, the watermelon is doing extremely well on this side of the garden. I believe I explained the other day that watermelon used to be on the other side of the garden. Apparently there's something on this side of the garden that it really likes and does not like on the other side. That is two plants. One planted on that row, one planted on this row. They're fixing to exit the garden, trying to grow. Here we go over here. One on this row, as you can tell where the black line runs, and one on the other row. They've grown together and they're all up, grown up, intertwined to a point of I can't get them loose. All right, we're gonna go down the pepper row real quick because it's getting dark here. Here we have basically green bell peppers. They're doing pretty good. They have some blooms on them here. Here we have jalapeno plant. It's got jalapenos on it. That looks about like 3-inch jalapeno there. There's lots and lots and lots of blooms on it. Very, very densely packed peppers. Very densely packed. These would be the Peter peppers. I'm not sure it's the first year I've grown them. I'm not sure how hot they are, but we're gonna find out. These plants are smaller. That is a good, oh, probably 6 to 8 inch banana pepper. This one here is the same way. We have two. This one here, ready, coming off. Maybe I can sweet talk mama into making a salad tomorrow. You never know. But here's what the rows look like. The potato row was right here from the very first video. Had the okra next to it, tomatoes on the right. And I went ahead and I ran the tiller down through the other side of the okra, just to kind of help it out a little bit. Need to run the tiller back down both sides of the okra and then weed in between the plants and get rid of all that green, because it's supposed to be brown and the only green you're supposed to see is the okra. There shouldn't be any green in between them. But the okra is doing pretty good. Okra is a very, very hot red plant. It wants to be in the hot. And believe me, East Texas, we can grow some okra. We're gonna plant a whole row, just see what happens. All right, so here we are in the kitchen. About a month and a half is what all the plants have on them, besides the ones that were growing before then. Pretty good banana pepper there. That needs to go up in a salad here in the next couple days. We've got several tomatoes. These are gonna be the pick right tomatoes. That's a real nice one there. Can't complain about that. This one of the tomatoes that you gotta love it. You know what this is? Apparently a bird sat up on top of this and gravity did what gravity does. But we also have these right here, the little splits. Pretty sure this came with a big old 6 inches of rain we had in 2.5, 3 days a couple of weeks ago. And the tomatoes were probably about this size here, where you can see it starting to split also around the top. This one was probably this size then, and it did go ahead and try to develop, but just too much water too quick. One of the reasons we picked all the, or dug up all the potatoes also. Little cherry tomatoes, or grape tomatoes, they look perfect. I'm liking the fact you just go down there and you wiggle the branches or whatever, they fall down and you pick up the tomatoes. Just wiggle the whole entire plant and they fall right off the vine. Perfect little for salads. Anyways, that's the update of the garden after the rain. So until next time, thank you for watching. Please comment. Please subscribe. Let me know what you think. Good, bad, indifferent. Until next time, thank you very much.